It's my Tana Tony. You know what it is. It's me and my little friends. I got my 300 Black out here, aka Blocka. You see what it is? Ooh, is she clean, boss?
Hey, before we go any further, boss, I'm not getting no money for this. Like and subscribe, please, and thank you, because I got mad giveaways coming. Y'all got to help me out, man. You really got to help me out, man. Help me get to making better giveaways to get to y'all. And you never know what you might get. You know what I'm saying? Let's do it.
Y'all know what it is. Side charging game. And we in here. So I'm going to get this loaded up real quick. I'm going to put like 4 or 5 mag. Got a magazine here. Going to dump out a couple rounds down there. And y'all was like real curious like how I grip this thing, man. This is how I grip it. See them shots? I'm here with Blocka. I got my 4.75 inch ARP chambered in 300 blackout. Ooh, look at that. I was already about to have a miss feed. Load that back up. All right, we got this target 15 yards away. Y'all see it way down there? Let's get two in the chest right quick. Y'all, we got a couple double taps real quick, military style, one in the chest, one in the head. Let's see where the target at.
You at work or you out chilling?
Not only are we gonna shoot at this target, we're gonna test out this new Amazon brass catcher. I got it for $13, but I think it's the build off the Fiyachi version or whatever that is. It does have an attachment, which is right here. All I do is put it on here, and it's on. And even though it's side charging, because of this model, it actually does allow the charging handle to reciprocate back and forth. So that is a bonus to me. That's a bonus. Let's get this thing ready, man. You see? We clear. We on safety. Look at that, man. All three shells. This thing works, boss. If you didn't think a shell catcher worked, man, or if you thought because it was from Amazon or whoop, whatever you want to think, boss, you're wrong, my guy. You're wrong because it's working.
Come on, y'all. Blocka. Look at her, all her glory and might. Y'all thought she didn't exist. Or y'all thought she wasn't real. She's a goat, man. She's a goat. Yeah, I know I closed one eye a couple times. Kind of did that just to see if it was too bright, in which case this is a little brighter than I want it to be.
30 round PMAG, 300 blackout style, 150 grain FMJ from Ammo Inc. I'm gonna put 4 rounds in there real quick and just let y'all see this thing bust back a couple times. All right, we loaded. Hold on, I got another camera. I'm trying to get y'all some good footage. Let me get this one. Let's see where we at.
Ooh, got a jam on the first one.
Got a jam on the first one. It did jam, as you can see.
Get that on the discharge. But it's working out, man. It's getting better. I still have one actually in there.
So now I gotta drop the mag to get this one discharged out. All right. Got that clear? All right. We got three in the chamber. Man, that thing jumped. I'm not even gonna lie. It came out of my pocket. It came out of my pocket and it just jumped up high, man. It just jumped up high.
All right, it's Montana Tony. We here, y'all. Finally, we got Blocker on set. I know y'all been waiting. Don't be mad. We here. So let's enjoy the content, you feel me? Because I'm finna show y'all what I did and 5 steps that I took to start this project. You know what I mean? Like, I want y'all to be able to really, like, just tune in with yourself and just understand me for a second before y'all start, you know, going in and going ham about stuff. All right, so off rip, man. Step one, application. When I'm talking about application, man, I mean, like, what are you trying to build? You get what I'm saying? And this is just a tool. So what am I mean by tools? This is just another intricate tool, just like anything else that you've been using on a regular basis, just like a vehicle, man. That's an intricate tool, man. That's a tool that's more complex than other forms of transportation versus what a bicycle, you get what I'm saying, versus what walking, right? Simple mechanics, you get what I'm saying? So we're going from like hammer and nail to going to impact hammer. Well, this is definitely impact hammer. So what do I mean by application, right? In this case, I wanted something small and compact, but still powerful. You know what I mean? Not to take away from majority of its capability, but just to be able to apply enough of it to be better than what most could apply in the same situation. In this case, you know, EDC, self-defense. That takes us into the next step, purpose. So my purpose for this tool was to be able to protect me in heavily obstructed combat situations. What I mean by that is I live in the city. You get what I'm saying? Hey man, I'm not trying to hit nothing 300, 400 yards away. Ain't nobody no sniper. You get what I'm saying? You know, somebody might pull up in a van or something like that, realistically speaking. You get what I'm saying? I'm in Atlanta. Somebody might pull up in a van or something like that, 2-3 dudes hop out. I don't got time for, you know, to try to play no games or nothing like that. You get what I'm saying? I just want to let you know. You pull up next to me in a van or SUV or whatever, you got 3 or 4 ninjas in there. A couple of y'all hop out too quick. La 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 la. You get what I'm saying? We gonna have a good time, boss. Don't move too fast now. I don't have time for that. I need a purpose, man. That's my purpose. I understand there's some, you know, there's some commotion gonna go on about that. About how I was explaining that. Of course, I am a law-abiding citizen and I'm going to always put the safety of others first, right? Anyways, don't come at me too quick because I'm gonna respond quicker, if you get what I'm saying. That's that. I'm just being realistic. You get what I'm saying? I live in that type of environment. So these guys, man, some people may try to tell you like, oh, you need these rifles to be able to, you know, or literally a rifle, like 16 inches or more barrel size length, right? Like, what are you shooting at, man? Like, I can see if you live in the country, you hunting or something like that. But I mean, I built this for my purpose. You got to build something for your purpose. You get what I'm saying? And that's what I'm just trying to tell y'all. Like, you gotta find an application to be able to apply it and then, you know, apply it to your purpose, right? I'm going with this, right? You're creating your purpose, you're applying that application to it, right? Let's just move on to step 3, research. So in this case, the majority of the research that I did, which brought me, like I said, from my application, I needed something compact, right? So I had to do research on compact applications to be able to handle my purpose. It's real simple, man. I needed something where I wasn't just stuck with some short buffer situation so I could have a brace. You get what I mean? I met around and I went to this. I needed something where, and this is clear by the way, I'm always clear on sight, man. These are always empty except for this one is just for show, but I never put nothing in here that is not, you know what I mean? So anyways, look, so I needed this, man. I feel like I needed to be able to keep this in a compact shape until I needed it. And if I felt like I needed that much structure, okay, now I got it. You get what I'm saying? We good. So I definitely needed that, and you know, I'm happy about that, and I'm happy that I decided to go with that decision. Now, another thing that I chose to go with was this charging handle. I know a lot of y'all was curious about, you know, the left side charging handle. I did not have to think too hard about this. Reason for this is that when this is actually on me like this, and I got this charging handle, you know, when you have this one right here, the standard charging handle, you got to pull back. So you have to remove your eye from the target. You lose target acquisition. We're talking about CQB here. I am close range. I am not taking my eyes off the target. If I need anything, you get what I mean? I'm not taking my eye off the target. If I need anything, I can load, clear the round magazine. I mean, you gotta like look into things like left side charging handles. Do you want your charging handle to be standard coming out the front? Are you left hand shooter? Do you need to, you know, have the charging handle on the other side? Or, you know, everybody likes the unicide most of the time. I think that's cool and all, but I did what I did because I was doing research, man. And through the research process, I'll tell you later how I came to getting closer to this build. So the next step that I really want to tell you, after you do research, you got to resource. So from researching to resourcing. Now that you've done your research, you got to resource the parts and everything that you need. I built this part from part. You get what I'm saying? Like I didn't build the parts, but I bought part before part. I'm talking down to the springs, the little tiny dentants that's inside, everything. I bought everything and I put it all together. It does not take you that long to put stuff like this together. That's something that you should be able to learn through the process of research, right? Through the process of research, you should know how to put together your application, at least in a form to where you could try to apply it to your purpose, right, man? I will tell you, in all honesty, a Gucci rifle, like what people think are Gucci ARs and stuff like that, I guess like Daniel Defense or some other ones, you know, like some, whatever, right? $2,000, $3,000. You will be surprised, even with this standard lower that's on here right now, this is already worth more than most of those guns. Even with this optic and what's just on here, it's because of what's inside. You know what I mean? The trigger and all that stuff. The upper alone is $400 plus tax. You're probably gonna pay some tax on that. You get what I mean? But you go through a process. I actually started with a Bear Creek Arsenal upper. You get what I mean? So when I'm talking about resource, like you gotta figure out like where to get these parts and everything to put together to build your tool. There are a lot of sites out there. I don't know if it's okay for me to share the link to those sites. I'll probably try to make one of those like secondary links that send you to another place to be able to find all these. But there are a few places out there that I could absolutely not tell you to go to. Like I could not tell you, like you can't go to places like Primary Arms or, you know, Wing Tacticals, or you can't go to like the, you know, Optic Planners, nothing like that. Like you can't go to those places and resource parts. Yes, you need to do your own research also on those manufacturers. You do the research on those distributors, those sellers, and determine and understand like who's able to offer you the best deal, who's able to pretty much quick delivery, because you don't want to wait all. I mean, I had to wait six months for this upper. You get what I'm saying? The lower is not even here yet, and I'm kind of overwaiting for it, and I'm already looking at something else. You get what I mean? So you don't want to have to wait for stuff like that. So go and do research. Make sure that they're gonna send your product not only in one piece, not only on time, but also make sure they're sending the original product. You get what I'm saying? Like make sure you're getting your product. Coming from resourcing and everything, now you got all your parts and stuff. Now you're putting things together. We're going to the last step. Not the final step, but the last step. What do I mean by that? Well, the last step is to test, but not just test. You got to repeat, man. So when you're talking about like how I got here, I had a different brace. Hold on. So when I'm saying like test and repeat, you got to put your tool together. You gotta try to apply it to your purpose, and you gotta make sure that it's performing to your purpose at the best efficiency or proficiency, whatever possible. You get what I'm saying, right? Like it just needs to perform for you as best as possible. So in this case, for test and repeat, I give you the example of how I went from this brace to this praise. Well, this is nice and all. Strike Industries, I figured that it's a really good product. They are an innovative company. I love innovative companies. I love broadcasting them out there to you all, especially when they have function and quality involved. Strike Industries is a good company, y'all. Yeah, they may throw their name on some products, I think. I'm not sure really, but whatever they throw their name on so far that I have by them has performed quite well. This handguard is actually Strike Industry as well, and it is amazing. This C oppressor in the front is Strike Industries, and it also has the compensator as well, which I'll maybe try to show y'all. Y'all have seen this from Strike Industries. Strike Industries is a good company, y'all. I got some other accessories from Strike Industries, but anyways, back to the brace, right? So I like this and all. Yes, it's sturdy. It's very short pistol brace. You know, it could fit well, but I wanted something that was not only more compact, you would be surprised. This brace is actually more compact. So I killed two birds with one stone, y'all. I got my brace to be more compact, able to get one built out of aluminum, and on top of that, I was able to get one with function. This one extends from a spring-loaded button. You get what I mean? So, I was able to maximize on that compactness. Now, I'm actually gonna go into another stage of compact because my original goal was, believe it or not, to make a Sig Rattler style AR. Well, it's gonna happen, y'all. So I hope y'all really stay in tune with me. So yeah, test and repeat. You get what I'm saying? Because what you're gonna end up doing is you're gonna get your tool together. You're gonna apply it to your purpose. That's gonna involve more research, right? Now you've gained more research, right? You go back to your resources and you determine if you can resource something that would allow you to make better application. You get what I mean? And then you go through the test and repeat again until you finalize it and you perfect your build. You get what I mean? So that's my whole process of building an AR. That's the whole reason I decided to go with an ARP. I have reason behind it. And it's okay because it's mine. It's not yours. It's mine. When you build yours, it's yours, boss. It's not mine. It's yours. You get it? So build something for you. You get what I'm saying? Build something for you, man. Hell, they talking about. And nobody care what they talking about. You get what I'm saying? Build something for you, man. Because you go build it for somebody else, you might as well give it to them. You know what I'm saying? You might as well just give it to them, boss. It ain't yours no more. It ain't yours, boss. You build that for somebody else. You over here, bah. You get what I'm saying? Instead of being a shepherd, man, bump all that sheep stuff. It's okay to take people's advice. It's okay to understand like what's good advice, you know, but hey man, and nobody should really just be giving you something that's just like try to force you to change, man. They should only try to help you better yourself. You know what I'm saying? Like, hey man, maybe this will help you better your tactics. Hey man, maybe this will help you better your build. Hey man, you thought about maybe doing this? That may help, you know, give you a better accuracy and help you still stay shorter. You know what I'm saying? Instead of somebody telling me to go from a 4.75 inch barrel, they'll say, oh man, that's not gonna do nothing. You're stupid, whoop-de-whoop. You know what I mean? Whoop-de-whoop, whatever. It ain't 10 inches, you don't know nothing. A 300 blackout is supposed to be suppressed. That's what they made it for. No, it's not, man. They made 300 blackout to be able to stay in a 5.56 casing and still give enough punch and similarities to 7.62, what is that? 7.62, 3.9, the AK rounds or whatever, you get what I'm saying? Or whatever it is, y'all know what I'm saying. And that's what they made 300 blackout for, just by chance, man. You know, it came from like, what, 300 whisper or whatever else, I don't know. Just by chance, man, it just happened to work pretty well with the suppressor. It just happened to work very well with a suppressor, man. CQB, boss, nobody is shooting more than 100 yards than anybody, boss. How you gonna explain that to the judge? 30 yards, 30 meters, boss. I got contact. You know what I'm saying? I got contact. I'm ready, man. I ain't stunned all that hunting stuff. I ain't stunned about trying to be no fake sniper, man. I've been done. I seen a lot of forms of combat, man. In our country, other places too. You see what I'm saying, man? So I'm not stunned that. You gotta build something for you, man. You gotta have fun doing it. You gotta learn what functions you can handle. How much you can train with. You know what I mean? You gotta do it for you, man. So that was just me just going through the process with y'all of how I really build out all of my tools. Application, purpose, research, resource, test, repeat. You get what I'm saying? And I guarantee you, man, you're gonna find what you're looking for. And I found it. I hope you find yours, man. And if you do, man, share it, man. Let me see. Tell me some stuff that y'all built, man. Tell me y'all stuff, some stuff that y'all built, man. Show me what y'all got going on, man. Let me see what y'all got. Hey, before we go any further, boss, I'm not getting no money for this. Like and subscribe, please, and thank you, because I got mad giveaways coming. Y'all got to help me out, man. You really got to help me out, man. Help me get to making better giveaways to get to y'all. And you never know what you might get. You know what I'm saying? Let's do it.